I've taken a look at your proposal. It's much better than the ones you showed me before, but I'd still like to make some changes.
Oh, come on, not again. Isn't this the sixth proposal I've shown you? What's your issue this time?
It's a bit hard to put into words, but the design still doesn't look quite right to me.
I have to say, that's a terribly vague and unconvincing explanation. Please enlighten me. What would feel more right to you?
For starters, don't you think this roof is jutting out a bit too far from the top? It looks almost like the head of a fungus. This door, too. I don't think it needs to be nearly this large. If you could reduce it to around my height, you could use the leftover materials to construct a few more rooms.
The roof and the door are the most fundamental parts of a building. If we were to change them, then what would be left of the design? Even if the soul of the building won't be lost, all traces of architectural style would be gone. Anyone with the slightest inkling of architectural knowledge would know to leave them alone!
Oh, I understand the principles of what you are saying, of course, but the truth remains that I'm still a bit unhappy with the design as is. Is there anything else that you can do? Oh, actually, I just got an idea. Can we get rid of all the extraneous sections on the roof? So the whole design will just be one vertical structure, similar to that of a tree trunk?
What?
Don't architects often say that symmetry makes everything more balanced and pleasing to the eye? This way, the proportions will be completely balanced.
I really don't know how you managed to come up with such a ridiculous idea. Wait, don't tell me. Someone hired you specifically to commission me and put me through the ringer? Come to think of it, though, I really don't think I've gotten on anyone's bad side recently. Anyway, that's it. I will not be working on this commission anymore. Goodbye. Maybe you can find yourself some other genius who'll be able to satisfy your demands.
Hey, young man, please wait!
Taking this commission was truly the worst decision ever. Oh, hey, actually, while we're on that, what are you doing here at the tavern? Don't listen to anyone who says that drinking is... So you saw all that, did you? I thought I was in the clear. I made sure to double-check that nobody I knew was around. Anyway, thanks for looking out for me. Honestly, it wasn't that big of a deal. I'm used to it by now. Stress is just an inescapable part of being a working adult. Boss, I'll have a glass of wine, same as last time. Do you want something too? I'll put it on my tab.
Wine and a glass of juice, coming right up.
I know you're already keeping a secret from me, but if you could add this one to the list as well, I'd really appreciate it. Arguing with a client is not a good look for me. If word gets out, other potential clients might be afraid to work with me. That guy, though. What was he even going on about? All those ridiculous demands of his? He's just a blabbering fool trying to act like a know-it-all. Another glass, please, boss. I'm not leaving today till someone has to carry me out.
You've got it, sir. I gotta say, though, it almost feels like you're saying that every other day now.
It really is every other day that you'd run into a client who knows nothing about construction requirements or architectural style. If this was in the past, I'd never have gone through six whole drafts trying to accommodate the client's preferences. But perhaps getting used to this just means that I've grown numb to it. I've worked on so many projects since graduation, and none of them have been approved at the first pass. I would spend a lot of time altering my designs, and by the time the clients were finally satisfied, all my passion and enthusiasm would be gone. It feels like I'm straying further and further from my artistic vision with every change I have to make. I suppose, though, that just sticking to your guns and completely disregarding other people's feedback would also not be a good thing. All of this makes for a real paradox, one that particularly crops up in my work, too. In the end, what is the true meaning of art? Should I see it as a divine gift of inspiration from the gods, or an expression of the light of my own wisdom?
Here's your drink. How are you already spouting nonsense after just one glass? Your tolerance is usually much better than that.
Boss, what do you think is the meaning of art?
The meaning of art? Really, my friend, who in Sumeru understands art better than you? Anyway, I don't know about art, but I do know that I'm interested in business, and some patrons are waiting to be served. So, you'll have to excuse me for now. Just holler if you need anything.
What do you think, traveler? No worries. It's been bothering me for a while. Even when I'm awake, the question haunts me. He understands nothing about my design. Okay, it is. Well, given I'm already on my sixth draft, I can probably push myself to make a seventh. Let's go have another talk with him. I know where we'd be able to find the guy. There's no time to waste. The wine can wait until another time. I'll go take care of the bill.
We're way behind schedule.
Cave, what are you doing here?
I've changed my mind. I was overreacting earlier. Can we try discussing the project some more?
My apologies as well. Now that I think about it, some of my requests were indeed a bit unreasonable. If I choose you to create the design for my project, I should have a bit more faith in your vision.
Thank you for understanding. Mutual trust is the basis for good communication. Now that we've got that out of the way, I think we can have a more productive conversation. To be perfectly honest, your commission request has been the most peculiar one I've ever received. Even now, I still know nothing about the building's intended purpose. All I know is that you want to build something in the desert for public use. I am aware that overly specific requests will restrain the architect's artistic freedom. However, knowing nothing about the intended purpose of the building also means I have no idea if I'm on the right track. I've produced several draft proposals for you to choose from, and you've rejected every single one. If we don't get on the same page, it could be a decade before we can finally break ground on this project.
Yes, I've given this some thought already. I think we can go with the general direction of the latest proposal that you just showed me. It's just...
Just what?
Putting the building design aside, can we get some less expensive materials for the floor tiles? I know someone in the business, and the red bricks he sells can go for pretty cheap. The timber here as well. We should be able to find some substitutes.
Please give me a moment. My head's starting to hurt again. Please hold on for a second. So, let me get this straight. You want to reduce the cost of the project, right? But if we implement your suggestions, then I'm afraid we have to scrap the entire design. architectural design cannot be neatly split into discrete parts. Any change to one part of the design will affect the quality of the whole thing. I decided to utilize high-end timber for this section because the weight-bearing structure requires the supporting materials to be durable and strong. Same with the tiles. Switch them out and the entire mural will have to be redesigned. More importantly, if we make such a change, both its practical functionality and aesthetic value will take a great hit. If all you need is a building with a roof that can keep people dry in the rain, you shouldn't have commissioned me. Many architects would be able to build you one of those while charging far less in commission fees.
Actually, Please tell me, are you absolutely sure that there's no room for any changes in this draft of the design?
I think the most important thing for me is to understand what you would actually like to get. If you could tell me more about your vision, I might be able to work with the design some more. You are the client, after all. You should have the final say on how the project turns out.
I want to build something unique. Something quiet and warm inside. A refuge that can block out the world outside. I want all who enter this building to be able to temporarily forget everything that's going on outside of the building and just focus on their task at hand.
That's a bit more information than last time, but it's still extremely vague. To put it another way, every rich person who wants to build a mansion for themselves would request something like this. We've gone through many proposals, and this draft is already the cheapest one. Cutting costs by substituting building materials will not only detract from the overall effect of the building, it also won't save you much mora in the grand scheme of things.
Thank you for giving it so much thought. Please, give me some more time to mull over the budget. I'll get back to you once I've figured out a solution. I still have a few business meetings that I must attend, so I'm afraid I'll have to leave for now. You can just leave the proposal.
I also have a similar feeling. He does seem really suspicious. That's actually pretty common. The more mora some people have, the more... Actually, now that I think about it, who knows how long construction will take if he keeps delaying things like this. We should find him again and get... Huh? Where did he go? I could have sworn he went this way. Let's keep looking. Oh, hey, look! Isn't that Badawi? It sure looks like him, but he's dressed completely different now. What is he up to?
Didn't I tell you before? I'm not looking for more workers. Plus, aren't you a bit old for physical labor? If something happens to you, I won't be able to pay for it.
Oh, you won't have to worry about that. I grew up as an Eremite mercenary and worked in the desert my entire life. My body's still in great shape. I don't have many talents, but I still have my muscle. If you need someone to unlock...
You used to be an Eremite mercenary?
I know there are a lot of bad apples in our ranks, but most are just trying to make a living. We're not that greedy by nature, and we'll do our best when given a job.
Let me think. I'm sorry, but I still can't take you in. I don't have any open positions right now, and don't have the mora for anything more. How about this?
Okay.
He used to be a member of the Eremites? Huh. From the way he was dressed, I would have thought he was a merchant from the rainforest. Let's ask him about it. We meet again.
Huh? Why are you guys here?
That's what we wanted to ask you. Who are you? Why did you dress up like a merchant to talk to me about our project? There's no need for us to continue this project if you still want to keep hiding things from us.
Believe me, I didn't have any bad intentions. It's just... All right, there's no point hiding anything anymore. The building I'm trying to commission you for is not really a personal residence for me, but rather a library for children living in the desert.
A library? Funded entirely by yourself? Shouldn't this be the responsibility of the academia? I've heard that the academia will be looking to prioritize the desert with the allocation of educational resources and materials. It sent over a large shipment of regular goods just last month.
You're right. And I was aware of these happenings as well. I just figured what I want to do is a separate effort from what's already being done by the academia. The desert is too vast. Even if the academia spends a lot of effort trying to disseminate knowledge in those parts, it might still take decades, if not centuries, to reduce the educational gap that already exists between the two regions. And what's more, I don't know if the academia would ever reverse its stance in the future. All I know is that as a desert dweller, we should not wait passively for good things to happen to us. If we only did that, we'd never be able to stand up and hold our heads high. I don't have much longer left on this world, so I just want to use whatever time I have to contribute something to my homeland. I didn't want you to know that I came from the desert. I've lived in the desert my entire life, and there wasn't anyone here that I could trust. I figured I needed as much safety as I could get.
To the point that you even disguised your identity? That's certainly taking playing it safe to the next level. Hold on. Don't tell me you've also been scammed before.
When I first came to Sumeru City, I brought a lot of Mora, hoping to find an architect that I could work with. Someone agreed to take on the project, and even took a sum of Mora from me, but then disappeared without a trace. After that, I heard that there are a lot of untrustworthy people in this business. Some would run as soon as they've been paid, while others would deliberately use expensive materials and take a cut of the construction funding. I spent a while collecting information in the city, and eventually learned that you're the most famous architect in all of Sumeru. I figured that you wouldn't need to make Mora by scamming people, so I decided to reach out to you. By the way, how did you know I was scammed? I don't think I've ever mentioned that to anybody.
Just a hunch. A while ago, I accepted an offer to work on a project in the desert, and was also scammed out of a large sum of Mora. I ran into someone who was living in a pretty run-down house. I noticed a load-bearing wall on the verge of collapse, and suggested that I build a new house for him. He said that he had no way to pay for it, so I loaned him some of my own Mora, and told him to get some stone and timber from the local vendors. Soon after that, I found out that he had gone gambling with all the money, and lost everything, down to the last coin. And after that, he even borrowed Mora from me twice more, using a different excuse each time. I didn't even suspect him of any wrongdoing until he hired a group of mercenaries and tried to ambush me in his own house. According to him, I looked like an easy target because I was an academia scholar who didn't have any family or friends in the desert. What kind of person would just look at someone else and think, this guy looks like an easy target?
Those kinds of things do happen every once in a while, yes. Folks like him are the exact reason why us desert dwellers' reputation have gone down the drain. I must apologize to you on their behalf.
It's all right. You were also scammed by someone from Kasharwar, after all. I should apologize to you on their behalf. Ultimately, neither of our experiences had anything to do with the desert or the rainforest. Yeah, you'll find both good and bad people everywhere. I can't understand the logic of those who like to take advantage of others, but I have to accept their existence as a fact of life. Anyway, I digress. Let's return to the topic at hand. Did you keep rejecting my designs because you thought I was deliberately using expensive materials to take a cut as a middleman?
That's what I was afraid of initially, yes. I eventually understood that you weren't out to cheat me. But unfortunately, I still don't have nearly enough mora to pay for the design you proposed. I've done the math and know that we should be able to make it if we cut some corners. However, after our conversations, I can see that you're passionate about your design, and I'm quite fond of the proposal as well. So, I decided to try and see if I can afford your proposal as is. I've been looking for work every day, and in another month, I should be able to cobble together enough mora to meet the budget.
By cobble together, you mean you're going to spend your entire life savings on this project? But then, what will you do if something unexpected comes up, and you find yourself stuck with no emergency fund?
To be honest, I haven't really thought about that. I mean, when you've lived to be my age and something happens, you can't really call it unexpected anymore. All I want is to build this library before I leave. A while ago, I heard that the Academia had decided to recruit a number of exceptional children from the desert. Of course, this is welcomed news. But as someone who spent their entire life in the desert, I still have a few concerns. I know the desert life and can predict what the problems will be. Many children from the desert have had neither the interest nor the proper environment. So even if the Academia would take them in, once they enter the halls, they...
Yeah, my father passed away at an early age. Even though I had a good number of... I'm sure a child coming all the way from the desert will have an even harder time. But let's bring this back to the building itself. I think building it according to the current plan will be quite costly. Even if I don't charge... Any ideas on what we can do? Most architects would probably prioritize cutting costs and removing extra features in this situation. Indeed, while it's true that the aesthetic value of a building is often viewed as an afterthought, neglecting it has some long-term negative consequences. It is especially undesirable in this situation, as the library will serve a high number of children, many of whom would have never been exposed to structures that may be considered elegant or beautiful. To completely give up on the more aesthetic design would mean stripping the children of an opportunity to appreciate the beauty of architecture. I share Badawi's sentiments in wanting to preserve a more complex design. However, if we can reduce the ornate aspects of the design while maintaining its fundamental elegance, which is to say we won't touch the arches and stone pillars but make changes elsewhere, this is definitely a first. To make up for the loss of regular details, we would need to put a lot of extra effort into the layout, lines, and color.
I see. Would that really be okay?
It just increases the difficulty of the design. You should feel lucky that out of all the architects in the city, you chose to approach me. Most of the others would have given up on this project by now. As for inspiration, I think I might have something in mind, but I'd need to visit the site to make sure. Where do you want this place to be built? Tell me the exact location.
Aru Village. Although it wasn't my childhood home, I think it'll be the best site for such a building.
Okay, then we can pay a visit to Aru Village.
Is there something I can do for you? I've already caused you a lot of trouble before, and now you're revising the design again because of me. Which draft are we even on now? It's making me feel terribly guilty.
Let me think. You said you used to be an Eremite mercenary, right? In that case, you could help us clear out some monsters that are blocking the way to Aru Village. We want to keep the roads clear, and reduce the loss of materials during transport to a minimum. If everything goes well, that'll help us save some mora.
All right, just leave it to me. If there's anything I'm good at, it's clearing out monsters.
What are you waiting for, then? Let's pack up and get ready to go. Most materials going from Caravan Ribat to Aru Village would pass through here. There are a lot of monsters out here today. If you find it hard to keep up, just let us know.
Oh, don't worry about me. This is nothing. I'll be careful, though, and you should do the same.
Sight clear!
Quake! I will have order!
There is no escape!
Take ya! Ha! Come at me!
Access denied! Shine down! Inazuma shines eternal!
I'm fine. I've spent my entire life fighting these kinds of monsters in the desert, but it's one thing to fight against monsters, and another to fight against an old injury. I don't think much of it back then, but with age, it's caught up to me. Few mercenaries get to enjoy their later years.
Is there someone you know who can help to look after you?
Unfortunately, no. My wife passed away at an early age, and I don't have any children. Sometimes I'd close my eyes and realize most of my life story has already been written. I joined the Eremites when I was young, and won many battles with them. My survival was more a matter of luck than actual ability. If at all possible, I want future children of the desert to have some more options in life. My apologies. The older we get, the more we tend to ramble. Seems like we've already cleared out most of the monsters. Let's hurry over to Aru Village.
I think it's really admirable of him to spend his whole life savings on people he's never met. Maybe he's doing this out of natural kindness. Kindness that hasn't been eroded away by the struggles of his life. Perhaps. To clarify, though, I don't think I'm quite the same. Some people call me an idealist. I do have some sentiments of that general persuasion, such as wanting everyone to be able to lead a happy life. But my situation is more complex than that. In the beginning, what drove me to harbor those thoughts was less idealism and more a desire to make up for a sense of guilt. When I was young, I impulsively encouraged my father to take part in the first Inter-Darshan Championship hosted by the... He set off confidently hoping to win something for me, but I never saw him again. I started doing many things in life because at this point, I've tried self-reflection, but it didn't help. Maybe it's just like what those Vahumana scholars often say. I could be doing things out of endless guilt, or I could be... Anyway, I suppose I don't really mind being called an idealist. I've known Al Haytham for many years now, and he told me a long time ago that no matter how strong of a swimmer you may be, I still believe I should live by my ideals. And I've given him countless reasons why I think it's a good idea to do so. Unfortunately, he remains unconvinced. His personality is, but as you can see, I'm not the only and when I finally run out of stamina, someone will help me, right? Oh, please. It's not like we're actually talking about swimming. Also, just so you know, I actually took a swimming elective back in the- Either way, I'm feeling much better than when you first found me at the tavern. I can feel inspiration. All right, let's head to... Now that we're here, it's my partner's time to shine.
Oh, what's this?
My toolbox. I built it using an ancient mechanical core. It's not too smart, but it's super useful and can help me with a variety of tasks. I'll take Marak and find a suitable location for the building. Once that is done, I'll get to work on a few designs.
Traveler?
Ah, you know each other?
Hello. I suppose you must be Kaveh from Kasharawar.
Educational assistance programs. Then you must be familiar with the local conditions here.
I can't say I'm too familiar just yet, but if you have any questions, I'll try my best to answer them.
I've been commissioned by Mr. Badawi to build a library in the desert. We've settled on the general design direction, but we are trying to finalize some details based on the conditions around the intended location.
A library? Do you intend to open it to the public for free?
That's right. I want to make sure the children will have books to read.
That's fantastic! I'm sure the children will be thrilled. Right now, we don't have access to many paper books or a quiet place to read. Truth be told, this very thing has been keeping me up at night.
Let me get straight to my questions, then. Can you estimate the number of children around here who'd be interested in reading? Besides the usual noise of village pedestrians, are there any other sources of noise in the village? Oh, and have any landslides occurred here recently? And also, where are the spots around the village that have been most affected? Alright, Badawi, let's go over the budget again. The parts of the project that cost the most will be... I want to make significant changes to the array. Our final cost should be around... Marak has produced a sketch for all of you to see. The inspiration just came to me I must give you credit, though. If it weren't for... According to the traditions of my profession, in the meantime, let's...
Be off work this early? There is still a lot.
We meet again.
Huh?
That's what we wanted to... There's no need...
Believe me.
A library? I've heard that the...
You're right. The desert is too... And what's... All I know is I don't have much longer left on this world. I didn't want you to know that I came...
To the point that you even...
When I first came to Sumer, someone agreed to take on the project. After that, I heard that I spent a while collecting information. By the way... How did you know I was scared?
Just a hunch. A while ago, I accepted an offer to work. I ran into someone who was living in a... He said that he had no way to pay for... And after that, he even borrowed Mora from... According to him...
Those kinds of...
It's all right. Ultimately, neither of our experience... Yeah, you'll find both... Anyway, I digress.
That's what I was... I've done the math and know that... So, I... To be honest... All I want is to build this life. A while ago, I know the desert, so even if the...
My father passed, I'm sure, a child coming all the way. But let's bring the... Building it according... Sponsor the project? You mean convince wealthy merchants to join our cause and pool their money together to build the life? That does make sense. A library is a big... What do you think? If we can...
It's all fine with me, but where do you think we'll be able...
Well, you're right. Her? Hard pass. With her shrewd and greedy personality, she would never put Mora into something like this. Now there's an idea. She probably won't say no if all she'll need to do is to make some introductions instead of... Let's go and pay her a visit.
just some unexpected guests. When I saw Kaveh, I almost thought it must be that time of month again. Sadly for me, I must wait a few more days before I can collect—
Hey, can't you think of something else for a change? You are literally living in an objet d'art, and yet your mind is still fixated on nothing but Mora? What is the point of wealth, anyway? Is your happiness entirely dependent on your hoard of cold and—
That's exactly right! Mora is extremely valuable, you see. If you don't keep your mind on it, your Mora may just find its way to somebody else's pockets. If you ask me, this place is still way too empty. Just give me some time and I'll fill it to the brim with lots and lots of Mora.
You're hopeless.
Oh, so you have an actual reason to visit me? Alright, let's hear it. Merchants? Why? Is there some kind of business opportunity? Oh, I see. So you're just looking for someone to help you foot the bill.
Ugh, I knew you wouldn't be interested in something like this. Still, you wouldn't refuse just making some introductions for us, would you?
Sure, I can connect you with some folks, but with every service comes a fee, you know.
A fee? You mean just for introductions?
Of course! Making introductions means using my connections and putting my reputation on the line. Why wouldn't I charge a fee for something so important? And since we've known each other for so long, though, I'll give you a huge returning customer discount. How about 500,000 Mora?
500,000? I guess that's okay. But why are you charging a fee before we've even secured any funding? That just doesn't seem right. Besides, by helping us out, you'd be doing a great service to the public. Can't you take your mind off your Mora even for just 1 second and focus on something far more important?
Very well. Since you're so passionate about this project, I'll help you out and waive the introduction fees. Three of my business partners came by earlier today to discuss some things with me, and they still haven't left yet.
Thank you so much.
If you can wait here, I'll bring them over to you.
Let me think. Where did I put the delivery?
Dory gave us a brief introduction about the two of you. You are Kaveh, the renowned architect, and you are the Traveler. Practically all of Teyvat has heard of you by now. To be frank, I don't feel like there's an obvious business opportunity here, but since Dory took the time to introduce you, we can spend some time to have a conversation. So, let's hear your idea.
All right, here's the situation. I've been commissioned to build a library in the desert, with the intended goal of allowing the desert dwellers to have more access to reading materials.
So, it's a public welfare project?
Correct.
Then the commission fees will likely be very low. You should be careful.
I'm not too concerned about how much I'll get for the commission fees, actually. I'm fine with doing it for free. I just want to get this project rolling as soon as possible. We're just a little short on funding.
So what? You can't possibly expect that we just cover the shortfall for you. Besides, what does a library in the desert have to do with us? If you want to build it yourself with your own Mora. Seems simple enough to me.
Hey, there's no need to be so harsh. They are Dory's associates, after all. Here, can you tell us a bit more about what we can gain from sponsoring this project? So we'd mostly be doing it for reputation and exposure? There is some value to that. It could make doing business in the desert a bit easier.
Well, just speaking for myself, I've got nothing in the desert.
I also have a concern. It feels like there's not much to profit from in the short term. But in the long term, the reputation gain also doesn't sound like it'd offset the cost of the sponsorship.
Then how about this? What if, instead of building a single library, we commit to an entire complex of buildings dedicated to culture and education?
Wouldn't that just cost more?
Yes. But in that case... Mr. Kaveh, please tell us what you have in mind.
I'll just give an example. If we were to build a library and a school near Aru Village, then the desert dwellers would gradually begin to migrate towards the area. A whole suite of buildings will be able to host more traffic, and thus drive the economic development of the entire area. In turn, that would lead to direct business opportunities. I've been to the desert several times. Although there are still many lingering tensions between the two regions, the amount of interaction has been steadily increasing, and in the long term, the desert will only become more and more important to Sumeru.
You do have a point.
Education in the desert is indeed an industry that has not been tapped into. If we can be the first to place stakes in the area...
And you just believe anything he tells you?
Even the greenest amateurs know that urban planning will affect population flow. If you don't believe me, you can ask anyone on the street to confirm it to you.
You!
Hey, why are you starting to sound like I'll hate them?
Wait, something just occurred to me. If we're going to build a library in the desert, Aru Village would obviously be the best place for it. But it seems we're not the only ones with our eyes on the village. I heard a rumor a while back saying a lot of land and buildings in Aru Village have already been secretly purchased by a big-name merchant.
What?
What?
In other words, if we try to join the fray now, there won't be much left for us. If we want to build a suite of buildings focused on education and culture, Aru Village is the prime location. If we want to build it anywhere else, we'll have to deal with a far larger list of problems. It's not impossible, I suppose, but...
Then there's no hurry. We can wait for Aru Village to develop more first and get into the market for expansion to other areas.
But if you were to do that...
Is there nothing else to discuss? Great timing! I pretty much heard all I want to hear. If there are no other urgent matters, I'll be on my way.
I'll be off as well. If you have any new ideas, please feel free to reach out.
It seems like the others are not interested in funding this, so no point in me doing this on my own. Let's revisit this another time.
Hey, guys, wait! Well, what can I say? I guess it went somewhat as expected. They are Dory's friends, after all. As soon as they heard that there's not much more in this for them, they lost all interest. Yeah, it's just another day doing business with people. But I can never get used to that. Those people never think of anyone other than themselves. Looks like we'll have to figure out some other way to get the funding. Let's go.
How did the meeting go? Wanna talk about it?
Please don't tell me that you're here to mock us.
What kind of person do you take me for? With the kind and generous Lord Sun, you can try to talk up the project all you want, but the facts will...
But this isn't just a business project, right? Also, if you already knew no one would want to partner with us, why did you still try to...
You might want to remember who your creditor is before you start talking like that, Kaveh.
I'll pay back every last coin that I still owe you, but that's a
All right, since you're so devastated about this, I'll set you up for dinner with another big-name merchant. In fact, I'll be inviting the most famous merchant in all of Sumeru, so I'll be counting on your performance.
What? Really? I would like to sincerely apologize for my attitude just now. So... Where would we be meeting this merchant?
Follow me. I suppose both of you can come.
You said you're going to introduce us to the most famous merchant in Sumeru. Well, where are they?
You still don't get it, huh? The most famous merchant in Sumeru?
Huh? So you meant yourself all along? Then why did you bring us here?
Well, I've given it some thought, and that complex of education and culture buildings that you mentioned does hold some promise. It'll be a pretty big Morasink, and I'll have to fund it all on my own, but that's not really a problem for me.
Seriously? Where's this generosity coming from so suddenly? Are you trying to scam me again?
The reasons are not important. What's important is that I'm willing to help you. However, you know just as well as me that once this project actually breaks ground, it'll start sucking Mora from my pockets like crazy. So, to cut costs...
I get it. I won't charge any commission fees, and I'll take responsibility for the entire project.
Splendid! Then let's sign the contract right away.
This way, the children of the desert will have some books to read. Their lives should improve a bit after this. Of course, there are a few things better than using my knowledge to help other people change their fates. I must thank you as well, Dory. I used to say you only cared about Mora, which might have been some prejudice on my part. Sorry for that. I will also try to pay back my debts as soon as possible. Now, let's have a quick discussion. Where would you want the library to be built? That will be the most important building.
There's no rush. I'll provide you with a copy of the deed when we get back. You can just use the address on the document to find the lot.
Huh? The deed? So hold on a sec. The person who has been buying up everything around Aru Village was you all along?
Oh my, did I not tell you about that? Yep, yours truly has been buying up all the land. I must thank you for bringing your ideas to me. Before our conversation, I had no idea what to build on all those lots. So, from my perspective, this has been a great turn of events. I didn't put much in and easily got a lot in return.
But what about my commission fees?
Huh? Didn't you waive those yourself? I was just gonna say that to cut costs, we mustn't procrastinate and should start construction as soon as possible. But before I could finish my sentence, you volunteered to waive your commission fees and even promised to take responsibility for the whole project from start to finish. I am so touched, really.
It's obvious that you used every trick in the book to deceive me. You deliberately paused for a long time while talking about the project and kept glancing at me with that menacing look in your eyes.
Huh? You really think so? Well, the contract's already been signed, so there's no point in dwelling on the details. You know what? I'll pay for tonight's dinner.
Fine. I'll drop the argument on the commission fees. But since you said you're paying for dinner, I'm going to order the best dishes and booze this place has to offer, and lots of it. Tonight, we're feasting until I've recouped my full commission fees. Mission was truly the worst decision ever. Actually, while we're on that, what are you doing here? Anyway, thanks for looking out. Stress is just an inescapable part of being a working adult. Boss, I'll have a glass of wine. Same as last time. Do you want something too? I'll put it on my tab.
Wine in a glass of juice?
I know you're already keeping a secret from me, but if you could add this one to the list. That guy, though. What was he even going? Another glass, please, boss. I'm not leaving.
You've got it, sir.
It really is every other day that you'd run into a client who knows nothing about but perhaps getting used to this just means that I've grown numb to it. I would spend a lot of time altering my designs, and by the time the clock. I suppose, though, that all of this makes for.
Here's your drink.
Boss?
The meaning of. Anyway, I don't know about.
What do you think, Trap? Yes, art should. Let's say that I. The problem is that it can be very difficult to. Sounds great. Huh? I mean, it's not. My mother is also an architect. Perhaps. In fact, unfortunately, I've barely. I did remember something else, though. At the time, she even told me that it would be great if I hadn't quite come to grips with my emotions. It's been a really long time. Either way, thanks for reminding me that I can invite you to come along. Ugh, thinking too hard about the words. If you want to stick around and see how this will turn out, you'll be sure to encounter. All right, then let's head back to. Who knew that the day would come when I. Let me see. Anyway, there's no more time for drinks. Alhatham isn't in, so feel free to sit where. Oh, nothing. I just didn't realize how much time had passed. I'm happy for her. I hope she'll be able to find happiness there. Anyway, enough about that. Let's see what I packed into this box. What are all these things? Oh, I remember. Obviously, I wouldn't call it anything special now, but I was less than 5 years old when I made this drawing. Now that I've said that out loud. Criticism and self-doubt have always been a part of the artistic. I admit that I may have spent a little too long questioning myself. Anyway, never mind. The more I talk about it, the less. Ah, my building blocks! It's been years since. Oh, and this blueprint. I was super proud of myself when I finished it, and put it in the same pile as my mother's sketch. Unfortunately, my mother didn't realize that I had put it there. When it was only a few days later that he finally gathered up the courage to pay my mother a visit. My mother took me with her to personally apologize to the client several times. She didn't scold me about it in private, though. Instead, she went over all the steps required to Let's see, is there anything else left in this box? Huh. What was this? Ah, this is my mother's notebook. When I was a child, Wonder why she didn't. If only I could. Hey, it's not a matter of time. Who knows? Maybe this time something. I could tell what you were thinking. I've tried my name. I've even tried stuff like. I wouldn't try that route again. So we could find someone who was. My mother was never really the one. Let me think. Is there still someone at the academia who would know my. You've never really heard of her? She's a famous Kasharwar scholar and leading expert in formal garden design. Professor Zaha Hadi published many works during her career, so she's older now and is no longer teaching at the academia. But if I remember correctly, she. Let's go take a look. We might run into her if we're lucky.
What am I supposed to do now? Forget it. I'll just head back.
Tainari? What are you doing here?
Oh, it's you. Good to finally see you again. I came into the city to buy some experiment reagents, hoping to bring them back with me to Gandharvaville. But as soon as I got here, I noticed someone banging on Cyrus's door. You've all heard of Cyrus, right? He's an ex-sage and Sino's adoptive father. I was thinking about going over to ask what's happening. That granny over there may appear old and frail, but her vocal cords certainly sound loud and healthy as ever.
Granny?
Yeah, she's just over there. You can go check out the situation yourselves in a moment. Kaveh, were you at the tavern?
I had a quick drink or two. Can you still smell the alcohol?
Drinking in broad daylight. Really? You want to pass out by the road and get run over by a sumpter beast like some mindless fungus, huh? And you, traveler? You didn't try to stop him? You look like a wreck, Kaveh. What happened? Are you feeling down again? You know what? I'm hosting a meal at Pardis DI tomorrow evening. Do you want to come?
Huh? Oh, I had no idea. Let me think for a moment.
All right. Then I'll plan on reserving two seats for you. I'll be heading back to Gandharvaville for now. I have
a granny who lives nearby.
Plan on keeping yourself locked in there, huh? Fine by me. If you're not going to come out, then I'm not going to leave. My tomato was growing so well, it had all the potential to become the best tomato this year, and you cut it straight from the vine!
I already told you I had nothing to do with it. Why would I take a tomato that's still weeks from ripening? You'd have to be awfully green as an investigator to think it was me.
Ugh.
You see, the word green here could refer to both the color of the tomato and the fact that your skills could use some.
Enough nonsense! Just come out and face me, you coward!
You're out of your mind. If I've actually done something wrong, then get a mantra and pull me out by force, why don't ya?
Oh, why you...
Professor Zahahadi?
And who are you? Oh, Kaveh. Fancy seeing you here. How long has it been? Come on, get over here and let the professor take a good look at you. Not bad, not bad. You've grown taller again.
Professor, what's going on here?
It's no big deal, really. A few of us old scholars got bored in our retirement and decided to put together a vegetable-growing competition. At the end, whoever loses will have to go up on stage and do a performance for the winners. Which brings us to our current predicament. My tomato was sure to win until a certain someone decided they couldn't bear to lose.
Hey, don't try to defame me in front of the kids! If we're airing out each other's dirty laundry now, then why don't we talk about you sneaking into Janot's garden the other night?
Ahem! Lucky for you, seeing these youngsters come to pay their respects today has put me in a better mood. I'll let you off the hook. For now. Come on, let's go. We'll take our conversation elsewhere. He doesn't need to be a part of it.
Yes, of course.
Is Farinak still doing well?
Yes, as far as I know. She left for Fontaine some time ago and started a new life for herself. She's still doing work related to architecture, though.
Ah, yes. I did hear about that. Did that upset you at all?
No, not at all. She's already sacrificed a lot raising me as a single mother.
That's good to hear. Your mother did struggle quite a bit those few years. It's probably a good thing that she found a new place to call home. Sometimes I wonder if things were harder for her because she was so beautiful. People were always drawn to her beauty first, only to realize she had a sensitive and vulnerable heart underneath. She was still quite young when she first joined my class as a student. Beautiful and radiant with her golden hair, yet quiet and single-minded. She seemed like a lass from some aristocratic house who was seeing the outside world for the first time. She had to make a lot of drastic changes in her life to raise you on her own. Even during her time in the academia, she was a thorough perfectionist. If she was unsatisfied with something she had made, she'd insist on redoing it, even if I was perfectly happy with it. She had many admirers, and they'd always fill up the first few rows of seats, hoping they could get closer to her sitting in the first row. If it were any of my other classes, you'd have found nobody sitting in the front. But every time I saw her, she was always in that same rigid pose. She'd have one hand on her forehead, with the other clutching her pencil. Her eyebrows would be knitted in a frown as she concentrated on the blueprint in front of her.
I'm sure she had many difficult moments in her life.
I'm not too sure. She never talked about such things. I do remember one time, though, when she got into a heated argument with a friend. She said something I found very memorable. She said, "True art cannot be understood, but as an artist, I wish some people could understand its meaning." If you ask me, that's probably the greatest source of pain for geniuses of their craft. It's extreme.
So that's how it is. I wonder if the password could be... I tried both just now. Seems those aren't it either.
What are you trying to do?
My mother left her notebook to me, but it has a password, and I haven't figured out what it is yet. I'm trying to learn more about her so I'd have a better chance at cracking the code. Thank you for all that you told us.
It's the least I can do. Talking to youngsters like yourself makes me feel younger, too. Honestly, your personalities are quite alike, too. You're both stubborn, and both a little awkward. Of course, I'm sure the similarities are mostly superficial. But so long as you continue to harbor those traits, you'll find I've taught a lot of students over my career, and in my experience, very few genius architects of Kasharawar ever found happiness for themselves. They would know exactly what they want to express and fight for it tooth and nail, which inevitably led to arguments with their clients. Some clients would choose to respect the architect's vision or just let the argument go because of the architect's reputation, but those are the rare ones. When Farnak first graduated, she was getting into arguments with her clients nearly every single day. I think it only got a little better when she met your father.
I see, but could he understand the designs my mother made?
No, I think they were probably beyond him, too. But despite that, he still stayed next to her, listening to her joys and sharing in her sorrows. Farnak had many admirers, but she ended up choosing your father. His support probably played a part in that decision.
So instead of understanding, perhaps all we need is just companionship. Huh. It worked.
Oh, was that the right password?
Yes.
Then you should be on your way, child. Find a quiet place and see what she wanted to say to you. Being the awkward person that she is, I suppose there were many things that Farnak could never say out loud. Instead, she probably left them in her diary, hoping that they would make their way to you one day. If you're ever in a mood to chat again, just come and find me here. You're always welcome to discuss architecture topics with me as well.
Thank you so much, Professor.
There's no need to be so formal.
I'll let you kids go. It's time for me to take another stroll around the vegetable garden.
I wonder what my mother could have written about.
They all say Zaha Hadid's class is the toughest, but I think it's actually not too bad. On the other hand, though, structural mechanics is definitely a pain, no matter how you try to approach it. I doubled down and managed to get through it. I met someone special. At first, I didn't think much. We decided to name our son Kaveh. I don't think a young... The bad news came. But I have to face reality.
Huh? Is this a drawing? Seems like it was done by my mother. This blonde man was probably my... From the dates in the notebook, she probably drew this more than 30 years ago. Maybe we were thinking too much.
The one who invited us to the gathering is the talkative woman introduced everyone to each. My husband seems to be friends with the man with long... I don't think I'd be able to become friends. That man is certainly very handsome. We were not acquainted with each other to begin with. Maybe my son will also partake in these gatherings in the future.
Who would have thought my mother used to attend that kind of thing? There's more written on the back. Oh, it seems like it was written to me.
Kaveh. I was both overjoyed and distressed when I learned of you. You are very talented, and I am confident that no one will be able to help you during your journey as an artist. But outside of your life as a creator, whenever you feel down, seek out a friend to sit and have a chat. You can accumulate joy and fulfillment by spending time with them.
So that's the answer she prepared for me. She really thought, well, now that I've read her words, the thought definitely crossed my mind. Although it'd be nice to get together with friends and chat the night away, I don't want to bring down other people's moods because I'm sad. Besides, don't most people hate the feeling of seeing... And don't forget, I'm also older than... Huh, you're right. Well then, I guess it's best that we go and join him for dinner. That means I'll owe him... You know what? I'm not going to overthink it. I'll see you tomorrow at Pardis DI.
Alhatham also got my invite, right?
That guy, he's never...
Are you sure? All right, then. I guess we won't wait for him.
Yeah, let's go. Maybe we should give...
Oh, sure.
You still haven't told me. What's the occasion for getting us together here at Pardis DI?
We're celebrating the end of the first phase of Kaveh's studies. I wanted to thank you all for the help you've given her along the way.
Then where's Kaveh?
She said she wanted to show everyone a bit of what she's learned, so she's still doing some last-minute prep at home. She'll be here shortly. Anyway, Let's get started. To tell you the truth, I'm actually not so confident that the second phase will go as well as the first. The curriculum will become a lot more involved, and I'm worried that she won't be able to get through all of it. I was hoping we could brainstorm about it together before she gets here.
I knew this wouldn't be just a simple free dinner. Is that why you also invited Al-Haytham?
Yes. I thought it would be good if we could all put our heads together about this. Anyway, let's take a quick trip down memory lane. What did you guys do when you ran into a problem that you didn't know how to solve? Or got assigned a project that you knew you weren't gonna finish on time?
Never happened to me.
I'd just pull another all-nighter.
You two are hopeless. Does-
Ooh, that's a good point! Confidence is the most important thing. Once you lose your sense of confidence, it'll become all but impossible to find the motivation to study.
This could be a potential direction. I have already redesigned the literacy curriculum, and I was originally hoping to ask Al-Haytham for his opinion, but...
It's very simple. Instead of focusing on the amount of material you would like to teach, focus on the amount the student would be able to remember.
Wow, you actually showed up. I could probably count the number of times you've actually come to gatherings like this on just one hand.
It's still more than the number of times you've managed to get a proposal approved on the first try.
As long as you're still aware. So, what made the difference?
That's your purpose for being here, not mine. Don't project your ways of thinking onto me.
So you're saying the only reason you came is to help Tainari with his brainstorming?
Precisely. Kale will have a long road in front of her.
Hey, just to get one thing clear. Even if Kale manages to make her way to the Academia, we cannot let her enroll in her Avatat. Kasharwar is obviously the best choice for her. She's been a trainee forest ranger for so long, she'll definitely be good with her hands.
What are you saying? Spontamad is the better choice. It's where I graduated from, after all.
Then what about Amorta? That's the Darshan her master actually graduated from.
There are only two other Darshans left. We might as well select all of them on her enrollment application.
You... I'm trying to have a serious discussion here. Traveler, you aren't associated with any of the six Darshans. In your opinion, which Darshan would be the best choice?
Well said.
Agreed. And my goal in inviting you here was to gather some thoughts on the execution of this second phase.
Phase 2 far exceeds Phase 1 in both curriculum complexity and the speed of instruction. I hope Kale has prepared herself for what is coming.
Hey, what are you thinking now? Please don't tell me you're planning on lending her those abstruse books from your home library.
Actually, I was thinking about lending her a professions guide.
I'll make sure to write, "Don't become an architect," on the front page of that. You're right, I can't deny that.
Is there another phase after phase 2? What's the ultimate goal of all of this? Are we trying to prepare her for a job in the Academia?
We don't need to think that far ahead. Hold that thought, though. I think my vegetable...
I'm telling you, that client had no...
Have you considered finding another client?
They're all the same. I haven't had a good night's sleep for months now. Who do they think they are, ordering me to alter my design over and over again just because they have some mora?
It's too late now to change careers. You might as well try to find some joy in the pain. Besides, you'll be getting up in the middle of the night to make edits to your own design even when the client doesn't request it.
No. That's not true.
Cheer up, Kaveh. I'll tell you a new joke.
We'll save that for the end, Sino. You can keep it to yourself until then.
I... Whatever. I'm not going to use my brain anymore. Let's drink tonight to our heart's content.
Thank you.
Alhatham isn't in, so feel free to say. Oh, nothing. I just didn't realize how much time had passed. I'm happy for her. Anyway, enough about that. Let's see what I packed into this box. What are all these things? Oh, obviously I... Now that criticism, I admit that I... Anyway... Ah! My building blocks! It's been... Oh... I was super proud of my... Unfortunately, my... It was only a few days later that he... My mother took me with her. She didn't scold me... Let's see. Is there anything else left in this box? Huh. Ah, this is my... When I was a child, I used... Huh. Wonder why she didn't take this notebook with her. If only I could. Hey, it's not a matter of... Who knows? Maybe this time. I could tell what you were thinking. I've tried my name. I've even tried stuff like... I wouldn't try that route again. Yeah, everyone's life journey is different. Ah, I just got... What do you think? I'm glad you agree.
Next on the agenda.
Of all the places in the academia, I remember this one most. When my studies got busy, I used to pull all-nighters here trying to finish my blueprints. Who doesn't miss their time at the academia? Life was a lot simpler then, and we all had far less troubles. I created many designs that I thought were beautiful in the House of Dana. I drew whatever came to mind, since... if I had to give a reason, it'd probably... The academia also had a rule that allowed scholars to annotate any physical books they came across. As a result... Here, this is a great example. This book, History of Ancient Sumeru Architecture, contains some analysis that I did many years ago. Huh? Why is Alhatham's handwriting also in here? When did he ever read this book? I guess it's probably from when we worked on that research project together. Anyway, he probably never cared to tell you this, but the House of Dana is where Alhatham and I first met. I came here to do my homework, and saw him sitting by himself next to that row of bookshelves. A group of Haravatat scholars were chatting near him, but he looked as if he was too lazy to join them. There was a pretty stark difference between him and all the rest of them. It was my fault for feeling bad for him. I thought he must have gotten into some kind of trouble and went over to ask if he needed anything, not realizing that...
Not realizing that you were in fact the one in a whole heap of trouble?
all hate them? Why are you here?
The House of Dana is a public space. Anyone can come here, no?
But shouldn't you be at the records room at this hour? You're not here to watch me make a fool of myself, are you?
You think I would derive amusement from watching you fall into depression over your life's various troubles? If that's the case, then I suppose I must have been entertaining myself for years. I came here to pick up a few files. If your voice hadn't managed to get through my soundproof earpieces, I probably wouldn't have noticed you.
All right. I admit I was probably overreacting just now. Probably not when he's right here with us. As his senior, I shouldn't try to tarnish his reputation.
There was nothing embarrassing or shameful about it. When I was still a student at the Academia, I once collaborated with Kaveh on a research project. A collaboration is usually... We had a number of differences, and they remain unresolved even today. But there's no point going into that right now. The more important question is, why are you at the House of Dana?
As a senior scholar, isn't it my responsibility to offer my friend a quick tour and explanation of the Academia's architecture?
I see. Then let me guess. Your next stop will be the pavilions around Rosanne Garden? Our famed architect sure loves showing off that corner to all his friends. Oh, and Kaveh, a lot of the books you annotated have been moved to the innermost section of that bookshelf over there. You'll have to dig them out yourself if you need to find them.
Huh? But why would you know that? Don't tell me you finally had an epiphany and realized that there's great virtue in respecting your elders' work.
Sure, if that will give you some self-confidence. Leave any words of thanks you may have to the ex-Grand Conservator. The last time he was here, he was complaining that he had received reports from current students, the main grievance being that the annotations are too long and difficult to read. As a result, the books you annotated have been moved to the back shelves.
What? But all of my annotations were extremely important! Instead of reporting me, they should have been thanking me for my service. The notes that I took, they couldn't have asked for a better analysis of those books. Okay, just you wait. I'm going to fix this right now. I'll dig all the books out and return them to the proper shelves.
Oh, we'll wait. Anyway, you were about to say he's feeling a bit down? Put through the ringer. What an interesting phrase. I assume he used those exact words himself. He probably did suffer quite a bit, that's true. He always spends a lot of time editing his proposals, with the goal of satisfying as many of the client's preferences as possible. But the satisfaction of one client will not translate to general satisfaction with his work. Many problems in life can only be solved by a fundamental change of attitude. As the leading genius of Kasharawar, Kaveh should have both the right and the confidence to reject any unreasonable demands. There are plenty of architects in Sumeru who are inferior to him in skill, yet far more irascible in temperament. What clearly his predicament is inevitable, since he holds other people's feelings as more important than his own. Of course, each person is different, and we should respect the paths that they have chosen for themselves. Admonitions will serve no purpose. People tend to succumb to familiar pitfalls, and this is especially true for those who believe it's their duty to carry more burdens on their shoulders.
Looks like you were having an enjoyable chat while I was gone. Were you talking about me by any chance?
What do you think?
What else is there to talk about? Surely no one would be interested in talking about the file. Anyway, you should take a look at this. Look at this comment on page 82. Dear Kaveh, thank you so much for annotating this book in such detail. It was a great help to me. See that? Now that's how a student should treat their seniors!
And it looks like you're already in a much better mood now. It really doesn't take much to make you happy, huh?
Me? Happy? I'm mocking that retired blockhead for being so full of-
Why don't you just move all the books yourself? It's not like he hasn't cursed you out before. What was that nickname he gave you while you were in the Academia? The Kaveh had a habit of scribbling and writing in all kinds of books.
Hey! You didn't need to bring that- Oh, actually, I also found a really old sketch in one of the books over there. See? Doesn't it remind you of something? Huh? Don't tell me even you don't get it.
Hmm? Don't ask me. This is the time you specifically put aside to brag about yourself. Feel free to hoard all the-
You- In that case, allow me to explain. Although this sketch is a little abstract, you can plainly see from the road plans that this was an original concept for the expansion of Port Ormos.
We can also plainly see that the designer was a huge fan of this project. It's the project he loves to talk about the most, second to the Palace of Alcazarzare.
If I don't keep bringing up the neat projects that I've done, how would anyone know that I was the one who did them in the first place? There shouldn't be any complaints about Port Ormos. If I remember correctly, the construction process was very smooth, everything was made ready ahead of time, and there were very few safety concerns.
There are indeed no records of any complaints about this project. A most impressive achievement.
See? What did I tell you? Come on, let's take a stroll through Port Ormos next. I'll tell you all about the designs I made for the place.
No need. It's almost time to clock out for the day, and I don't intend-
Suit yourself. It's not like you know- Port Ormos. No, I didn't design any one specific building. Most of Port Ormos had already existed since I was still a young child. It wasn't as... The Arch Bridge over there, for example. That was... When I was first tasked with the project, I decided to reference... We ran into a lot of issues during construction, but thankfully, residents can now behold all the ships entering and leaving the harbor from the vantage point of... I was still young and new to the trade back then. Like the true cornerstone of the creative... Once built, a building will continue to stand. Countless... You think so? I'm glad to hear that. But my budget was tight, and I was unable to use the higher quality timber I had... Us creative types know better than anyone that most... Yeah, you're right. I should learn to look toward future opportunity. We've spent long enough here. There's still one last place I want to great. Most of my projects over the last few years have had something to do with the desert. This is a rare opportunity, so why don't you come along and see it for yourself? If you ever feel down, maybe you'll be able to go there and feel better too. Thought that so many primal constructs could have congregated. We won't be able to sit and talk peacefully with these guys around. Let's clear the air. Sight clear!
Crumble!
Born of ice and frost! Blaze over!
Stabilize!
Let the show begin!
Ha! Ha! This is order.
There is no escape. Now you shall perish.
Isn't this place great? I often come here to clear my mind when I'm dealing with a difficult... You know what I mean. Everyone... Just take me as an example. My family life got shaken up... Although Alhatham thinks that it's because of my personality that I continue to live in the shadow... You could probably say I followed in the path of my mother. Like her. Life is too boring when you live with no enthusiasm and passion. Of course, I will concede that loving something also means taking it to heart. But still, isn't this place beautiful? Despite the erosion from the winds and change, with different landforms come different architectural styles. The desert's history has left it with few records regarding its buildings, so I often visit the desert to investigate. The sight here has moved me ever since the first time I laid my eyes on it. My pain will one day fade into nothing. They are far more valuable than most materialistic things, and far more. If you were to ask me what art is, you think so? But I remember that question I brought up before? The one about whether I still haven't found an answer to that yet. Those who pursue art will be unable to avoid the pain that it naturally brings. I'll try gathering my thoughts again once I've found a way to define. In any case, thank you so much for listening to everything I had to say.
But human life is like the dew at dawn.
Taking this commission was truly the worst decision ever. Hmm? Actually, while we're on that, what are you doing here at the tavern? Don't listen to anyone who says that. Stress is just an inescapable part of being a working adult. Boss, do you want something too? I'll put it on my tab.
Wine in a
I know you're already keep that guy. Another glass.
You've got it.
It really is, but perhaps get. I would spend a lot. I suppose the all of this.
Here's your drink.
Boss.
The meaning of. Anyway, I.
What do you. Exactly. So our thoughts on the in Sumeru, and especially it's too. Sounds great. A different career. I think I've heard a. It's just a saying, of course. And if I want to make. Hold on. I just. Maybe I'll be able to get some.
On the agenda?
Hey, it's you!
Yeah, it's been a long time, Alkami.
I heard that you were the genius behind the Palace of Alcazarzare.
Well, it's hard to make a profit.
Hard to make a profit? Unless the client fled before they paid.
Well, about that.
I understand. Either way, I mean, I obviously never had your reputation. Not exactly. Judging from the look on your face. You're still strapped. With that said, us Kasharawar,
Are you serious? But something like that has got to be some kind of top-level business secret. Are you sure you can just share something like that with me? Besides, I don't want to just take something like that without offering anything in return. I still have a little Mora.
Oh, you're too kind. This is just a simple tip. Even if I didn't bring it up, I'm sure you'd hear it from the others sooner or later. The idea is this. I recently opened, compared to the classes taught by those old fossils at the academia, my classes are more condensed and streamlined and will allow people to quickly get their foot in the door. Unlike the academia, I won't turn down anyone who's interested, rich or poor, as long as it just so happens that I'm still looking for a few more instructors. So, what do you say? Interested in coming over to give a few lectures? Regardless of the pay, I can already guarantee that it'll be far more comfortable than work...
Ah, so you want me to join you as an instructor? That does sound like something I'd be able to do. That sounds like a pretty stable job, too. What do you think, Traveler?
Then it's a deal?
Yes, it's a deal. Thank you, Alkami.
Like I said, there's no need to thank me for this. The lecture room is not far from here, so you can just come. As for the pay, how about we start at 300,000 mora per lecture?
300,000? Are you serious? How could you offer so much?
It would seem that you're still oblivious to your own economic worth. 300,000 is nothing compared to the prestige of having the Light of Kasharawar as one of my instructors. 300,000 is also just the base rate. Just trust me on this. The longer you stick with me, the more you'll come to understand your true value in the market. I have to go make some preparations now. See you tomorrow.
I was never particularly close with Alkami when we were in school. Who would have thought that he'd be so nice and friendly? I've hosted free lectures before, but this would be my first time being hired to lecture for a formal business. Thanks so much. I think I will be able to relax a bit more with a friend in the audience. Now, what should I talk about tomorrow? Some lessons I've learned over the past few years? I should probably save those for later. For my first lecture, I should start by getting them more interested in the field. All right, let's meet here again tomorrow morning. I should hurry home and create some kind of lesson plan. If I'm going to become an instructor, I should make sure I show up prepared.
Expect you two to get here so early.
I was up last night preparing for the lecture, but I ended up getting so excited that I couldn't fall asleep. Here, I've prepared a lesson plan.
Lesson plan? I must commend you for your dedication. But the training center has already developed its own set of teaching materials. Instead of using your own plan, you can just use what we have here. Of course, you're always welcome to work in some of your own content to add some fun and flavor. Sure, be my guest. It's almost time for the lecture to start. Feel free to head in and start the class whenever you're ready.
So you've already developed your own set of teaching materials. Seems like I won't need the stuff I've prepared after all. Anyway, shouldn't be a problem. I'll just go ahead and use your materials. There's something else I want to ask, though. This isn't going to be a large class, is it?
No need to stress. There are only 20 people in this class. There are 14 classes at my training center. Out of all of them, the first class has the best grades, so I've directed them to you. We'll see how well they take to your lectures.
20 people, huh?
One last thing. In the interest of keeping a quiet learning space, only instructors and students are allowed in the classroom when class is in session. I'm sorry to say this, but your friend will have to wait outside while you teach the class.
Sorry about that.
Hey there. Can I help you? Oh, Akami? You mean that rich guy who's been making quite the name for himself? I heard he earned a fortune working as a renowned architect. Now he's opened a training center so others can follow it. If the tuition wasn't sky high, I'd enroll my child in a heartbeat. Architecture...
Did you hear? Akami recruited Kaveh to be an instructor.
I bet that'll boost his enrollment numbers.
Really makes you jealous, eh? If you think about it, Akami was never that talented himself as an architect. If we're just talking about professional skill, no one would pay for a class with him.
That's true, but you've got to admit, his advertisements are really effective. After all, the academia only admits those that can pass its entrance exam. So only a few people could hope to study architecture in the halls of the Gasharwa. For those who can't pass the exam, or who just want to jump straight into the industry, the training center is the best bang for the mora.
Man, to have that kind of business acumen.
All right, everyone. There's no need to be nervous. Class is over, so we can just chat for a bit. I shouldn't have lost my temper during the lecture. Did I scare anybody?
No, you weren't scary at all, Mr. Kaveh. We were just...
Ugh, don't get me started. I was trying to use Alkami's materials, so I flipped through some pages and gave them a closer look. The more I read, the more upset I became. Alkami may fool an amateur, but he can't fool anyone who's active in our profession. The materials he made are completely... In my opinion, the most important skill of an architect is their ability to craft a design. In other words, they must be able to conceptualize ideas. There are tens of thousands of buildings in the world, as well as a countless number of architectural styles. Some designs emphasize aesthetics, while others prioritize practicality. The architects who can critically evaluate the quality and fit of different designs are those who can come up with great designs of their own. But you won't get any of that from the teaching materials they're using here. All these students are doing in class is rote memorization of existing designs. They are learning nothing about the underlying principles. How can they expect to become real architects? When they're done with this class, all they'll become are dilettantes with a pitiful smattering of architectural knowledge.
But, Mr. Kaveh, we didn't really understand anything you said after you threw away the materials either. What's the big deal anyway? It's not like we're looking to make some works of art. We just want to make some mora.
You're studying architecture to make mora?
Yeah. Why else would we be studying here? My biggest dream is to become someone like Mr. Akami. Once I finally make my fortune in architecture, I'll be able to buy anything I like.
In that case, I'm afraid you'll probably be disappointed. The reality is that the work of an architect is very difficult, and the pay is not lucrative at all. Believe me, I'm a perfect example.
But how? Mr. Akami just told us last night that you made a killing by building the Palace of Alcazarzaray. He also said that as long as we graduate from his class, waves upon waves of people will reach out to us with private commissions, and we can just sit back and wait for Mora to fill up. It won't be long before I can put these miserable days behind me.
Come on. And you all believed everything he said?
But Mr. Akami is really rich, isn't he?
You... It's pointless trying to argue this with you right now. You've already filled your heads with pipe dreams. Let's go, Traveler. Let's hear about Alkami's true plans from the man himself.
What's wrong, Kaveh? You look quite flustered. Did one of my students offend? Were the students not astute enough for your liking? I must implore you to go a bit easier on...
Yeah, I'm mad at them. But I'm even more upset that you're scamming people under the guise of teaching them about architecture. The students are all here hoping for a quick way to make money. But we both know that an architect's life, if your client is unhappy, you can't break ground. And the longer a project goes, the longer it takes for you to get paid in full. You know all of this just as well as I do. Why
Luke Carvey, you may be the light of... You may deny it all you want, but it's a fact that our clients care very little for the effort we pour into our Why should we cling on to a profession that's difficult and unrewarding? If it's near impossible to make money as an architect, then why not just establish a training center? And
wait, how does that make any sense?
We are already stuck, my friend. That's right. Making money as an architect is a slow and agonizing process. In comparison, none of the students will ever know, however. In the more students I get, the more money I earn.
And then what? Once they graduate, they'll still find out the truth about architecture and struggle to stay afloat amid all the problems we already talked about. When that happens, your facade will pop like a soap bubble. No-
Ah, but that's just one way to look at the problem. No two people have the same amount of talent. Even if they fail to strike gold in the future, you can't say... Oh, and also, I never actually promised that they would achieve financial freedom as long as they become architects. All I did was nudge them towards that belief. I'm not even scared if they do come back and stir up trouble. My training...
You... How can you sleep at night knowing that you're doing all this? I can't believe that I once saw you as a decent human being.
And the same goes to you. How many years has it been since you graduated from the academia? If you still can't accept something like this, only fools will see art as revered and sacred. I urge you to think about what I've said. Offload as the light of the Kshara-war, you've accumulated plenty of fame. Think it over, Kame. I still believe our
mad. I feel a headache coming on. There's nothing more I can say. Of course. I'm sure you've realized that as long as I remained at the center, he would be able to... He is right about one thing, though. These kinds of the most that they could accuse him of is false advertising. Oh? Did you notice something else? Yeah. You've got a point. The rate he gave me was 300,000 mora per lecture. That probably came out of the students' tuition. And who knows just how much he's been charging the students for attending his class? If you're gambling everything on making it rich as an architect, are you really go- Right. We should hurry. The students didn't be- We're never going to get any information from them again if we let Alkami talk to them first. Let's move now before he's had the chance to react.
Mr. Kabe, what are you doing back here?
Class finished a while ago, but you're still here. Why haven't you gone home?
I wanted to stay for a little longer. I'm still thinking about everything you taught during the class. Even though...
Of course they were! All the examples I drew were world-famous landmarks. Each one was the magnum opus of a celebrated architect. It's a good thing that you could recognize them for their beauty. The accumulation of knowledge is the first step to artistic expression. Instead of rote memorization, you should try to
resonate?
Yes. When I first got into architecture, there were many things about it that I couldn't understand at all. I would find a building to be beautiful, but have no idea what... And for most people, just being able to admire a building is enough. To become a good architect, however, going from admiration to assessment will take a lot of time and specialized knowledge, and I'm afraid that some superficial speed training won't be enough to take you there.
Just as I thought. Becoming an architect won't be as easy as Mr. Alkami made it out to be, right?
I'm sorry. I'm not trying to crush your dreams. All I want to tell you is that an architect's life is not as carefree and easy as others may make it out to be.
I understand. Thank you for telling me the truth, Mr. Kaveh. I think I'll still stay here for the time being, though, since my family still hasn't paid everything off.
Hmm? Paid off what?
Sorry, I can't say anything more. Mr. Okami made it very clear that anyone who talks about it will be kicked out.
Don't listen to him. I am the most famous architect in Sumeru. If he kicks you out, then I'll just take you in instead.
Really?
Why would I pull your leg? I can see you have some talent. So as long as you get your fundamentals
Then please, Mr. Okami was the one who reached out to my parents. He told them that he told all the students that once we graduate.
How much did your family borrow?
I think it was several.
And what was?
I'm not really sure.
Yeah, I have a bad feeling too. We need to find that merchant to confirm. But if we were good idea.
We last saw him on the north shore of Port Ormos. Who knows if he's...
Well, it'd still be worth taking a look. Architecture... No, we need to do something before the students' lives are ruined even further.
I don't think I've ever seen you guys before.
You're Fahar, right?
Yes.
Alkami. My friend here wants to enroll in his architecture.
Oh, sounds like his business is boom.
Let me see. I'd say around 3 million.
Oof. You call that a bit short on money? Anyway, here you go. Don't worry, there's nothing particular.
And what if they won't be able to pay it?
What do you mean, won't be able to pay it back? Once you graduate from Alkami's place, and even if you were to run into some difficulties and need to delay the installments, it's hard work running a business. If we're taking risks to supply you with mora, it's only fair that you take on a bit of the financial risk as well. Anyway, there's no point in tying yourself in knots over the contract. With the way you're...
I just did some calculations in my head. When you say the interest, of course the contract did a great job of trying to obfuscate that fact. It only listed the amount that you'll have to repay every day. If you actually do the math, however, it's clear that the amount you need to pay on interest alone will amount to hundreds of thousands of... Even my creditor doesn't dare to raise rates that high. Once a family signed onto a scheme like this, there's no getting out.
What are you trying to say, huh? I figured something was off when two well-dressed people came looking for a loan. Think you got the better of me? Too many people are sticking their noses where they don't belong these days. Luckily for me, though, this is a pretty secluded spot. Hey, come out and teach these guys a lesson!
Eremites? I've already fought off more than my fair share of them when I was working in the desert. There are only a few of them, so they shouldn't pose much of a threat. Marak, you're up!
That's following orders.
Feeling lucky today?
Scanning.
Where access do you think enough. You're going? Illusion shattered.
Oh, no!
Come at me.
Shine down.
You won this one.
Where do you think you're going?
I'll be back.
Who are you and what do you... I don't think we've done anything to hurt or offend you.
Debt has the power to append your whole life. I know very well just how but my debts are the culmination of many different factors, and my... But these students are different. You sold the dreams of becoming an architect to the students as bait, urging them to take on insurmountable amounts of debt to satisfy your greed.
Ha! Everyone knows there's no such thing as a free lunch. It's their own fault for falling into the trap. And if we're going to talk about greed, aren't those students the ones who are blinded by it? They completely ignore the risk that's right there in front of them.
Ha! And here comes the silver tongue. Surely you use that to reel in. People grow by learning from their mistakes. I hope this will be a value. Let's head back to the academia and turn this guy over to the Matra. They should be able to link him with Alkami's business. Sino?
My vacation just ended not too long ago, so I'm going over some cases at the academia. I see. Charging an interest rate over 30% indeed constitutes a crime, as it is highly likely that Alkami is also benefiting from this scheme. The Matra will open an investigation on him as well. Any funds we manage to recover from the suspects will be returned to the students.
That should still be enough. Once the students realize the error of their Anyway, thank you for your help. I hope this won't be too much trouble for you.
It's no trouble. Just another day at work. How did you two... Did you accept...
He promised to pay me 300,000 mora per lecture, but I resigned as soon as I finished the first session. I didn't take... What do you mean, that's good? Would you have taken me into custody as well if I had actually accepted it?
I wouldn't have gone that far. But, had he insisted that you were also an active participant in his schemes, under our rule... Either way, though, I believe you are innocent in all of this. Had you actually been all right with making money...
Hey, what was that? What do you mean my life is a mess?
never mind.
You're just messing with me now, aren't you?
Let's get back to business. If Alkami's case can be successfully resolved, you'll be eligible for a monetary reward from the academia.
Huh. I didn't even know there was such a thing. I never would have guessed. What I'm trying to say is that we didn't report Alkami.
The reward will be given regardless of your personal motivations. It was implemented with the intent of encouraging people to supply tips to the Matra.
Fine.
Is there anything else?
I want to go back to the training center one more time and talk to...
Sure. But you should wait until tomorrow. My subordinates will shut down the center today, and summon the students to gather information on the total amount of mora they've lost in the scam.
Alright, then I'll stay out of their way. I can talk to the kids tomorrow.
I have a few other things to take care of, so I'll be off for now. If you want to follow up on this case, just come find me again. Or ask one of the Matra.
Phew. That should finally be the end of that. Ugh. Who would have thought it would turn out like this? All I wanted was to find a new gig and earn some mora. To think Alkami would sink this low, it still makes me really upset. Still, I think I feel a little better now than when you found me back at the tavern. It's a little ironic, but you could say it's because I've realized that there are many circumstances in the world that are even worse than my own. Now that I've seen such things firsthand, I suppose I've earned a new sense of appreciation for my life. How should I put it? I'm pretty stubborn when it comes to my profession, so I often argue with my clients. The arguments are usually extremely frustrating, and every once in a while I'd wonder if I only became an architect because fate wanted me to pay for some sins I'd committed in a previous life. Alkami's suggestion would have allowed me to quit my life as an architect and earn money solely from my reputation. But now that I've experienced that for myself, I can... Every scholar has their own sense of pride and a line that they don't like to cross. Of course, when faced with the vicissitudes of life, some will surrender these things to seek a more comfortable life. Just speaking for myself, though, I don't think that's something I'd ever be able to do. The voice in my heart would just keep repeating one thing. The moment I turn away from my dream, if I stopped devoting everything to my creative activities, I'd be able to lead a more comfortable life. But at the same time, at that point, any materialistic ease I may have gained in life would just become another form of torment. In comparison, my current I appreciate it. You may call me conceited for this, but I would also like- It's certainly not easy, but I want to keep at it. My thanks again for being such a great help throughout all of this. I'm planning to pay another visit to those kids tomorrow. Want to come with me? All right, I'll see you tomorrow then. Get some good rest.
De-stress.
The training center has been shut down, and the Madra have promised to return some of our tuition, but we've already spent so much time on this class. What should we do next?
Mr. Kaveh said we can keep working on our fundamentals and try to get into the academia.
Ha! Easier said than done. If it was only the best of the best can get into the academia studying on their own.
Mr. Kaveh might be willing to teach us.
Why? What reason does he have to stick around?
So, you're the only one-
Huh?
Now, that's Mr. Kaveh to you. I'm here as your I'll keep instructing you for a while longer. You can pass on the message to the other students. As long as someone wants to come, they can join the class. Oh, also, I'm usually pretty busy, so I'll only be able to teach architecture fundamentals on my days off. Another disclaimer, architecture is not an easy profession. Aesthetics aside, even the basics of safe design can already be a handful. If you want to design safe buildings, you'll have to go through a systematic study of structural engineering. And just as a heads up, all of this will be a huge step up from the superficial stuff you were learning before. It'll take both talent-
We'll try our best!
It seems some of you are really serious about this after all. All right, everyone, pack your stuff up. No need to prepare much for today. You'll know once we get there. Come on, let's get going. We'll be off once everyone's grabbed their pencils. This lighthouse has been around for a long time, and I handled its renovations when I first- The point of today is not so much about the lighthouse as a building, however. I just want you to take a look at it and do a bit of self-reflection. If you were tasked today with designing- Don't think about how you'd actually go about building it for now.
So, it can be-
Yep, as long as you think it'd look good. It doesn't even- In my experience, it's best to approach the study of architecture from a point of Both the study and practice of architectural design are extremely difficult. A person who's forced to work on projects that they don't resonate with, so at least for today, I hope the students will be able to create something that they enjoy. There's no need to think about it. What do you think? Want to try your hand at it as well? Don't forget that this is a free class.